So Karnataka is witnessing a huge spike, not just in COVID cases, but also in COVID fatalities. Karnataka's revenue minister, R. Ashok, has dropped a bombshell. The minister said that 3,000 COVID patients have switched off their mobile phones and since remain untraced. The minister said that the Karnataka police have escalated the manhunt to track those COVID positive patients who just disappeared. They are no longer on the government grid. The government is tracking those telephone numbers registered by these COVID patients. And this revelation comes at a time when Karnataka has reported the biggest surge in cases in the state with over 39,000 cases.
ಸುಮಾರು 20% ಜನ ಕೋವಿಡ್ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಅಂದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ಮೊಬೈಲ್ಗಳನ್ನು ಸ್ವಿಚ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ದಯವಿಟ್ಟು ಮಾಡಬೇಡಿ. ಅದಾದಮೇಲೆ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಕೋವಿಡ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆದಾಗ ಮತ್ತೆ ಸ್ವಿಚ್ ಆನ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಆಸ್ಪತ್ರೆಗಳಿಗೆ ಅಲಿಯುವಂಥ ವ್ಯವಸ್ಥೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ನನಗನ್ಸುತ್ತೆ ಸುಮಾರು 2-3 ಸಾವಿರ ಜನ ಈ ಥರ ಸ್ವಿಚ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಮನೆಯೂ ಖಾಲಿ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಏನು ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಈಗಿರುವಂಥ ಒತ್ತಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಪೊಲೀಸರನ್ನ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕಿಂಗು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀರಿ, ಆದರೂ ಕೂಡ ಅವರು ಸಿಗ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ ಇನ್ನು.
India Today's Nolan Pinto now joins me for more on the story. So Nolan, how can 3,000 people just get off the grid? Were some of them hospitalized? Were they under home quarantine? What happened? Give us details.
Well, Gaurav, these 2,000 to 3,000 odd people whom the revenue minister R. Ashok stated are missing from the grid are basically who were all in home isolation or home quarantine. So what the government is now facing is this. All those people normally, if you're infected, you're at home in home quarantine, they would call you. The BBMP would call you, make calls. The health department officials would make calls. They would find out if everything is all right. Are your vital parameters all under control? That's the reason they say you keep an oximeter at home, check your temperature. So you let them know what's happening. Now, what's happening is that 2 to 3,000 odd of them, their mobile numbers are basically, it's completely off. They do not know where they are, that is the officials. They do not know if they are still right here in Bengaluru. They do not know if they've actually left the state. They also do not know if they've actually gone to various other districts because their numbers are switched off. There's no way to trace them. So what the government is doing is that to track and trace them as of now is the numbers that they've given, they're trying to find out their address, go to their residence or their homes and see if this person really lives over there. And if they are not there, if the neighbors could actually tell them where they have gone, they have no other option, Gaurav. In spite of all these cases, the police now, there's this one more burden for the police to go and track and trace where these people are. So these people, according to the minister, are also could be one of the reasons why we are all facing this surge. They're just going out mingling with people and they've already done that.
Very, very unfortunate. Stay with me, Nolan. The other big story, and this perhaps, and talk to the doctor in your neighborhood. Can this be emulated across the country? This needs to be replicated. Residents of Ranka Heights apartment complex in Bengaluru, they've turned their clubhouse into an emergency quarantine center for COVID patients. Now, this complex has the clubhouse rooms that are equipped with oxygen concentrators, PPE kits, nebulizers and lots more. Now, this goes a long way in reducing the burden on hospitals and to deal with an emergency without much hassle. Now, in several such localities, there are doctors who live in that locality and they play a big role in looking after those who've tested positive but may not require hospitalization or ICU facilities.
They call it the emergency medical room. And this is the story of proactive citizens fighting to be useful. Amidst a frightening COVID surge in Bengaluru, residents of the city's Ranka Heights apartment complex have converted a part of their clubhouse into two EMR rooms to treat any resident who turns COVID positive and suffers from breathlessness. The EMR is a quick interim medical center on site to provide necessary support for a COVID patient with emergency respiratory relief for a short period to stabilize them. Residents have ensured that the clubhouse now has equipment identical to a hospital emergency room. From PPE kits, oxygen concentrators, nebulizers and more to help a patient who's struggling to breathe. 8 to 10 residents of this apartment complex have volunteered to be trained by the local Manipal hospital to operate this medical equipment. They connect with a doctor who assists them as to what is to be done. When any resident complains of breathlessness, this is their first point of contact.
So there is the PPE gear here. So as you can see, there are a few extra kits as well. In addition to that, we also have the oxygen breathing tubes, which is used for the oxygen concentrator. So to connect it to the machine for it to work properly. We also have a nebulizer as well. I think each of these equipments that you can see here are available for us to use, and we will use them depending upon the criticality of the situation. So once the doctor confirms what needs to be used, we will be using the equipment accordingly.
They also procured 3 oxygen concentrators, one of which is a mobile oxygen concentrator, which can be taken to a flat in case a resident cannot come down to the clubhouse. But why did they set this emergency medical room up?
Even last year, there was a very strong feeling within the management committee that this can go out of hand, right? And we could see, learning from the US and UK and other places, that ICU beds will go in short supply. Oxygen will not be available when it's required. And so we were more like, you know, I mean, let's do it as an initiative for the community.
The system has proven to be a very effective model that could be replicated at apartment complexes, not just elsewhere in Bengaluru, but across the country. A life saved in an on-site emergency room of this kind means a bed at overwhelmed hospitals could be spared.
This is a good initiative and something that we believe that various other apartment complex in Bengaluru can also follow. You have your resident welfare associations over there. If you're actually watching this, try this. In the meantime, while you're waiting for an ambulance, the person over there who's suffering from COVID, suffering from breathlessness, can be taken care of and a life can be saved. With video journalist Madhuar, Nolan Pinto for India Today.
Hello everyone, this is Rahul Kamal here. Hope you enjoyed this video. For the latest news and analysis, like and subscribe the India Today YouTube channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated.